Hey, what's up guys? This video is going to be about an error, and that is if you plug an external drive or connect a virtual drive to your PC, you hear a sound and you know that the drive is connected but it does not show up in Windows Explorer. This happens when Windows 11 or Windows 10 does not assign drive letters to USB or virtual drives automatically. Most people know that they can fix this by going to the disk management, but your virtual drives does not show up there. Stay tuned. In this video, I will show you two possible solutions to fix this problem permanently. My name is Mazhar, and at Right Solutions, I create tutorial for all you DIY people. If you're new to my channel, please don't forget to subscribe and press the bell icon to get the notification for my next video. Now, without any further ado, let's get to this video. For solution one, come here to the search bar next to the start icon and type here services. And now this services app had come up here, so just click on it to open it up. And now as you come into that app, so just click onto this name tab once or twice to just reorder the files by name. And now just look here for virtual disk. Select that virtual disk and look at the status for the virtual disk. Mine is running, yours may be not running. So in any case, just right click on it and click on properties. And on this dialog box, I'll just stop my service first. So just click on stop. If yours is running, you can stop too. And now you can just click on start again, so the service will restart. By the way, this restarting of this service, you can do it from this left top here. So you can just stop or restart from there too. So now from here, just come on this startup type. You see mine is automatic. So yours possibly not automatic. So just pull down this menu here. And out of these options, you have to select automatic. Yours possibly disabled or possibly selected manual. So just pull down and select automatic and then just go and click OK. If your apply button is not grayed out, so you can just apply. You can just click on apply and then click OK. And now close down this services app, and all these changes what you have done in services app, to get this in effect, you have to restart your system. So just come to the power button, click on restart, and if your problem is solved, that's good. If not, then you proceed to the solution number two. For solution number two, come here to the start button here and right click on Windows icon. And now in this menu, just look for the option terminal with the administration rights. So just click on it. The PowerShell window will open up here. So just come on the command prompt here and type disk part and hit enter. And now you are into the disk part directory. So type here auto mount and hit enter again. And now you can see that it is also giving you the information of about the previous state of your auto mount. So it says automatic mounting of new volumes disabled. So we need to enable it. So just come back onto the command prompt here and type again auto mount, give a space, enable, and hit enter again. And here you can see this new information says automatic mounting of new volumes enabled. So, but wait, we are still not done here. One more thing to go. So come back again onto the disk part directory and type here auto mount, give a space and type scrub. So auto mount scrub and hit enter again. And now the new information says disk part successfully scrubbed the mount point setting in the system and automatic mounting of new volumes enabled. So we are done here. So now you can just type here exit. And you can also close this PowerShell terminal as well. And now you need to restart your system again to get this all changes in effect properly. So just come and click on restart and wait till your system gets restarted again. So that's it for this video today. If you think this video added some value, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel. I will see you with the next video. You have a wonderful day.